Welcome back to my YouTube channel. It's been a really long time. I'm now home. I made it through basic and through tech school. I know I didn't have a lot of updates in between. My main focus was just getting through the program, getting good grades, passing. So I didn't get to video a lot of stuff. I was kind of busy studying. You do have roommates, so just sharing that space. And not really having a whole lot of time to do this kind of stuff. So I apologize. I do have so much to update you guys on. I kind of just wanted to talk about the dental assisting program in itself, because I know that a lot of people don't have a lot of information on that. I know that from experience, because I remember when I was looking into the program and there wasn't a whole lot of information. So now that I went through it, I'm able to talk about it and I'm really excited. The first thing was, so the morning we arrived at Fort Sam, it was really, really early. The night prior, we were obviously still at basic training in the dorms. We were packing, saying goodbye to all our flight mates. You really just don't get a whole lot of sleep. You're kind of just packing, saying goodbye. There's no MTIs, so you're kind of just chilling for like the first time in a long time. And so there's some airmen that get you off the bus, and we went to the drill pad. We handed some paperwork in. We have briefings all week long. It's kind of transitioning from that basic training mindset into tech school. The briefings were just, you know, the new rules, getting you prepared to start classes and setting you up for success for those. So that was about a week we sat in briefings, and then we started class. The program is really fast paced. I want to say the first week we probably had about, sometimes we had about two PCs in a day, two to three in a day. So PCs are just progress checks. You get a book and you read ahead, and when you come to class, the instructors will review that with you and then you will PC on it. So throughout the course, you have PCs, you have labs, and then you have an end of course test. So all the PCs, and then at the end you have one big test. So there's five big tests, which isn't bad. The program was a lot of fun. The instructors, they really try and get you to finish. Like, they do not want you to fail just as much as you don't. So I want to say, as long as you pay attention, you will do well in the program. I don't want to say it's easy, but if you apply yourself, you will definitely surprise yourself. I ended up getting Dean's List. That was a big accomplishment for me. I didn't know that you could actually get Dean's List. Once I heard that, I made it a goal. So another thing that is really cool about the Air Force Dental Assisting Program and basic training that I didn't know is you earn college credit. So at the end, you have a good amount of hours towards a degree. It's called your CCAF. I haven't been able to look at that, like how many I have acquired, but now that I'm at my first duty station, I'll start to get a feel of where I'm at as far as like education and building on that. You are given a chance to take your ICE and RHS, which is your infection control and your radiation health safety, I believe it is. So those are two DAMBI tests, which are your Dental Assisting National Board tests. So the last one that you need is chairside. You do take that outside of tech school, but again, you get to take the RHS and the ICE while you're in tech school. The Air Force pays for both of them. They give you books, they give you what you need to study for them, and then they will take you to a building and you get to take those at tech school, which is really cool, because if you pass both of those, there's these things when you become operational, you start CDCs, which is basically just going more in depth in your job. I'm pretty sure everyone does CDCs, so it's a requirement. Everyone does it. It's just something you do when you get operational. However, if you do pass RHS and ICE in tech school, you will be exempt from doing the first set of your CDCs, which looks amazing as a first-time airman. It prepares you to be a certified dental assistant, not only operational, but if you ever decide to get out and you're certified as a dental assistant nationally, that's amazing. I did not know that going in. I ended up passing both of mine. Don't know how. So I did study a lot, and I knew that if I studied and I didn't pass, I knew that I at least tried my best. I was prepared either way. I wanted to really, really pass. But if I didn't, I knew that I applied myself. I did what I could. Again, the program went really fast. It was a lot of fun. It was so nice to go from basic and be in a classroom with people from my brother Fly, my sister Fly. It gave me an opportunity to meet even more people. Tech school is definitely way more relaxed as far as basic was. They are slowly preparing you to be more of an individual. You go from basic being so structured that you kind of need that slow transition. Going through tech school through COVID, we didn't get to do a whole lot. We didn't ride in taxis. We had to march everywhere. We were not allowed off base, and on Fort Sam, you are not allowed to drink. It was manageable. It wasn't horrible. I mean, I haven't went through school being able to do those things, so it was fine. It's not like I could compare it. Definitely doable. I did it. The dental assistant program overall is a great program. The leadership there is amazing. Again, if you study and you apply yourself, you will make it. You will surprise yourself. You might even get dean's list or honor grad. So as fast as it goes, the comforting thing is whenever you go operational, a lot of people that are going to be in your shop have went through the same program. So they will understand that you are a new assistant and you do get extensive training even after tech school. If you are looking into this program and you have any further questions, you can contact me. I am not operational just yet. I am actually in ROM right now, but I will be here in the next couple weeks, so I'm really excited to get started. Again, if you have any other additional questions as far as the program, I can make a video, and I probably will be making a video about basic training. But if you have any other additional comments, questions, concerns, you can comment. I will make a video and I will be updating you guys as I go. Again, I apologize for not making a whole lot of content while I was in tech school. My attention kind of got directed towards school. But yes, I will be updating you guys a lot more. Thank you so much for watching.